Hi, I'm Artem Grabovski and welcome to my YouTube channel. At first, I want to say big thanks to the first subscribers and also for the first donations on the Patreon platform. If you want to support my YouTube channel, you could use the link which is placed in the description. Now, let's switch to our topic. Today we'll discuss structured logging. In this video, we'll take a look at general concepts of structured logging, integration of structured logging into .NET projects using NLog provider, and demonstration of structured logging in data analytics tool. Sometimes structured logging is also named semantic logging. Generally, it's a practice to implement consistent and predetermined message format for our application logs that allows them to be treated as a dataset which could be more easily analyzed and searched in data analytics tool than a plain text logs. Let's open a pretty standard plain text log file. Here it is. It contains standard information about timing, information about log level, information about logger, and information about our message. And let's discuss several situations. The first one, it will be pretty simple. We want to get information about our error logs. Are we able to make a stable search query to search these error logs? I think no, because it's possible situations when our log level will be info and we'll have additional error word here and it will not work as expected. We could take more complex situation. Imagine that you want to get a statistic how many error logs you have per each logger type. Do we have any efficient solution for this one? I think no. And we could take even more complex situation. Currently we have logs which indicate that payment has been created, and currently we want to get all error logs where payment has been created, where payment amount is less than $100. Sounds impossible? It's possible, but with structured logging. The goal of structured logging is to bring more defined format and details to our login, which could be easily searched and analyzed. Let's try to put everything into practice. Here I've prepared a test API project, which contains just one controller, it's a payment controller, and one endpoint to create a payment. Here we have an API service, and implementation is pretty simple. We have login that payment creation started, payment amount validated, we are preparing our response model, and we are logging that payment has been created. As you see, we are using login abstractions from Microsoft library, and we are using NLog as our login provider. Here in the root file, you could see a configuration for our NLog. Also, our major configuration for NLog is stored in a separate file. The first configuration is old one, and it's used for plain text logs. Here you could see that we are using a file target. We are specifying our file name, and here there is our layout, so it's a plain text layout. And currently, let's take a look into configuration for our structured login. And the major difference which you'll see is our layout. Here it's a JSON layout. We are specifying the list of attributes, time, level, process ID, thread ID, logger, message, and exception. And also we're including all our event properties. And currently, let's take a look into API service and how our log format is specified. So here we are using a high-performance login. I plan to make a separate video regarding high-performance login in .NET where we could discuss a lot of details regarding this one. Let's take a look into the first log steps. Here we have a log which indicates that payment creation started. It's implemented using a high-performance login, and here we have two catch and delegates. Let's take a look into the first one. We have a log level here, event ID, event name, and our format string. The most interesting part is the following one. We are passing the wall object to our log delegate, and we want to properly log the following object. For this one, we could use additional character here. It's additional indication for our login provider that it's a complex object and we want to log it in JSON format. And here we have a second catch and delegate, which indicates that our payment has been created, and we are also passing a complex object here with the following character as indication for our login provider. Here we have a log which indicates that payment amount was validated. Let's take a look how it's implemented. It's also implemented using a high-performance login, but using a compile-time login source generation. We have event ID here, we have event name, we have level, and we have our format string. Please pay attention that here we don't have any complex objects, we have just a decimal amount, and we don't need to use any additional character. So here it's our message format, which will be logged. Now I propose to start our API and take a look into our log file. So let's start. Okay, so here we have our endpoint. Let's make several test requests to create a payment. The first request, second request, and one more request. And let's open our log file. Okay, so here it was a null part which was related to plain text, and here it's a new part. Here you could see that all our logs are written in JSON format, and we have a separate JSON properties for time, for level, for process ID, for thread ID, for logger, and also for our message. And pay attention on logs which are related to payment creation events, and also for request started events, that all our objects were logged in JSON format, and also we are logging information about our event ID and event name. Now, let's try to add our log file to data analytics tool, which is named Splunk, which I recommend to use on your project. And I also plan to make additional videos regarding Splunk usage. So here we are signing in, and we want to add additional data. We want to upload our log file. Okay, we are selecting our file. Here it is. Download it. We are going to the next steps. Let's create a new source type. Here you can see our logs. You could just keep default settings here. Okay, and let's start searching. Here you could see how our logs are displayed in data analytics tool. Here it's our structured login, and here it's our plain text login, and you could see the difference. Even if you take some logs with complex objects, for example, here we have event payment created, we have a complex object payment, it's logged separately, and we have information about amount and payment ID as a separate JSON properties. And currently let's try to run several queries. At first, we want to get all our error logs. We could use the following query. Unfortunately, in our file, we don't have any error logs, so we could change to info log level. And we'll see that request was executed successfully. And currently, let's solve more complex situations. For example, we want to get all our logs which are related to payment created event. So we are just writing event name, payment created. And here we could see all our logs which are related to payment created event. And we could take even more complex situation. We want to get all payment created events where amount is less than $100. So we are writing that payment amount is less than $100, and you will see all results here. And currently we want to build some visualization for our time chart for payment created events. So we could just write time chart and specify count. Here you'll see information about how many events we had for each timestamp, and also we could have some additional visualization. So we had several events here, and we have a new events here. Now you know the general concepts of structured logging and how easily integrated into your .NET project. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe. I will be grateful if you also support my channel on the Patreon platform. Link is placed in the description.